How's it going, guys? Welcome back to another Anthem video, and today we're going to be talking about enemy weak points. Now, this is something that's been raised as a question multiple times towards Christian Daily. We don't actually have an official response on this, if there's going to be any changes, any differences. We do know that AI is being worked on and that the enemies will be a lot more responsive as to the drones that are currently available in Anthem 1.0. However, should they just be tweaked to be a bit more reactive, or should we expect more? That is pretty much what this video is going to be based upon. It has been a question that's been put to me through my Patreons, so I thought I'd make a video and have that discussion, and hopefully have some influence potentially based on your comments as well, because I know the devs do watch these videos, so keep your comments coming and let's have that discussion. So let's get down to it. Currently in the world of Anthem, all the enemies kind of feel the same, barring the big brutes where they have the shield. Essentially, you've got the tank that is their weak spot, or you've got the headshots, and every other enemy, whether it's a dog or it's a humanoid or it's a scar, they all have a similar weak point. It is the head. Now the question here is, should it remain the same and just be a flat rate, which I know for many of you out there will be acceptable because you just want simple mechanics where you go in, plot those shots, and get done? Or would you prefer to have a deeper involving mechanic that actually allows you to do more damage if you want to? Currently, the enemies don't have any elemental weaknesses. Elemental weaknesses would add a whole new element. Now, currently in Anthem, weapons that we currently have a set designation with either a laser beam or fire attributes or something like this. But the main form of attack is kinetic. Now, this can obviously change, and though we've got elements like acid that can actually weaken the enemy, what about the actual elements of fire working together with, say, ice? So if you've got a weapon that deals ice damage, having an enemy primed with fire, then adding ice onto it could either magnify that combo when you detonate it, or actually add additional damage before the combo comes along, makes that reaction. Think of games like Genshin Impact currently, where elemental fusion is all the rage. If you don't elementally fuse your abilities, you don't overload, you don't electrocute, you don't superconduct. When you get these abilities going off in Genshin Impact, that is what deals silly amounts of damage. Now, I'm not saying this is absolutely needed for the world of Anthem, and some of you might agree that it's not needed, but it's definitely worth mentioning in terms of elemental weaknesses on how it can work and what the developers can do about it. Scar having low resistance to fire, for example, would make sense. Other creatures around Bastion having elemental weaknesses to something else that you can exploit would also make sense. This would then go even further when you're trying to do, say, a stronghold that's scar related. You would take fire based weapons in there, but then you may also want to bring other weapons if there are other enemies. Think stuff like Destiny, when you have elemental shields that require the same element to destroy. Things like this all add an element and a creative thinking in order to actually achieve the said task without having to just go mindlessly and blow shit up. Now, obviously, that might be all you want to do, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with that, but this is just another angle of approaching this. We also have had the same type of enemies, and even with the pirates coming on board, they just look like a fusion between the Scar and the Outlaws. They just look humanoid, and obviously they are going to be humanoid because they're pirates, they're humans. But I'm hoping as they go along, they will also introduce new types of enemies that will have different weak spots, not just the headpiece. For example, the Vex in Destiny have a weak spot within their stomach, so you're not always just aiming for the head and hoping for the best. It does require some variation depending on what enemy you're shooting. And this is the sort of thing that I'd like to see in Anthem. I think it is needed, I think it will add a whole new diversity, and I think it is something that, if done correctly, can actually add a really cool mechanic to the game. Obviously, everyone's going to get used to it and it's going to become second nature, much like it is in, say, Destiny, in Genshin Impact, in even The Division. With The Division, when you're coming across the brutes, you can shoot them in the head and do maximum amounts of damage, but if you look at the heavies, they've usually got like a tank on them. You blow up the three tanks and that pretty much kills off the enemy. Stuff like this, I think, is always beneficial to the game, and it makes the world of difference. To go a bit further on the actual weak spots, the firefighters, the normal humans, not the bigger heavy-duty characters in the division, but the standard enemies that run around that are flamethrowers. They also have a canister on their back. Yes, you can shoot them in the head, and that will do a lot of damage, but you can also aim for the canister that will then add an explosion, which will then make the enemy explode and damage everything else around it. I'm not saying this game needs to be a Tom Clancy or a Destiny or anything of that kind. It needs to be a game of its own, but it's always good to borrow stuff that are actually successfully working from other games that are good, right? You leave the bad, then you take the good. There's enough games out there where you could actually start borrowing stuff and make it your own. Secondly, unique boss battles. You know, the monitor was pretty meh. There's really nothing to that. It's just shooting his weak spot in the head. But maybe if there was like a mechanic there that actually you had to do, and then once you've done that mechanic, it opens the boss up for a period of complete DPS carnage. Something like Destiny does a lot. You do the mechanics around, once you've done the mechanics, it opens up a window of 10-15 seconds where you can bombard the boss. Now, I like that mechanic to a certain degree, but I would also like to be able to do damage to the boss even while that mechanic is undergoing. And maybe that is something that they can look at, providing that the damage received is maybe reduced by 50%. If you want to get maximum damage out, you'll have a core of the team going and doing the mechanics while the other part of the team is dealing with the boss. Something like this is always, in my opinion, a plus point and definitely something worthwhile. Boss mechanics is crucial, especially if they're planning on doing anything that's like a raid, because raids are where the endgame content will be. You want the endgame loot to be there, and I'm not sure how they're gonna do that yet. Strongholds, in my opinion, just won't cut it. They need to supply more. They need to supply a content loop that will get you going and continually striving to get stronger with better loot, with better roles, and trying that pinnacle content. And in my opinion, pinnacle content generally means something like a raid or an encounter like Outriders is doing, where they have like 15 dungeons already set up that you can go and tackle at the hardest difficulty to get maximum reward. There are separate encounters, nothing rehashed, nothing reused, no recycled content, and you just go into those events and you do them with your team. Something like that would also work in Anthem. So I'm not saying specifically it needs to be a raid, however, what it does need to be is creative and not just your mindless shooting. The Skari boss in the Temple of Skaar is actually not bad. You have to shoot the vents, they reduce the shield, and then you get a window of opening. This is the type of thing I'm talking about. That is really the only boss you actually have anything to do with. Every other boss you can just continuously shoot, and it's just a bit boring. So what do you think? Let me know in the comments section below and let's have that discussion. Like I said, I know the developers are watching these videos and they do read some of the comments in the chat. So let's keep it clean, constructive, and let's have that discussion. I'd love to hear from you all, and hopefully we can steer this game into a better place. With that said, if you have found this useful and enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that like button. If you're not yet subscribed, because many of my viewers show that they're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. It really helps the channel grow, really helps the video grow. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay up to date with all content I release. With that said, thank you for watching. Thank you to all my Patreons for your continued support. If you want to support the channel, you can do that through my Patreon. You can also support me through the YouTube program by hitting that join button and becoming a member of the team. Thank you for everything, thank you for being here, and until the next video, stay safe and remain legend. Thanks so much for watching my video. If you look over to the left, you'll find a video that I'm recommending to you that I think you might actually enjoy. On the right, you'll see a video that is recommended by YouTube. I really do hope you enjoyed the video, and until the next one, remember to always remain legend.